Welcome, friends and family. We are gathered here in the presence of this company to join together this man, Michael, and this woman, Stacy, in matrimony. And if anyone can show just cause why they should not be joined, speak now or forever hold your peace. Keep in mind, I'm from Brooklyn. That could be problematic, especially you.
He's a Cowboy fan.
He is? Oh. I'm not into hockey, so. Anyway, we extend a warm welcome to all those present, as well as all those we invite here in spirit, as we gather in joy to witness and celebrate the uniting of two individual lives. Stacy and Michael have brought us here to confirm what has already been affirmed, that they will join together as husband and wife, man and woman, true friends and lovers for all time. In their love, respect, and devotion to one another, they will unite in the sacred bond of marriage and dedicate themselves to their true love, happiness, and well-being as soulmates and lifelong companions. Now, the essence of a marriage relationship is openness to another person and loving one another with depth and compassion adds richness and profound meaning to our lives, because love is one of life's greatest gifts. And as companions in your day-to-day lives, you take pleasure in sharing your time, thoughts, feelings, adventures, and these become the rhythm between devoted life partners as you build your life together. And when you give of yourselves into a loving marriage, you do not shed your individuality, because that's what brought you together in the first place. So I'd like you to continue looking at each other and remember this moment in time. Before this moment, you have been many things to one another: friend, acquaintance, companion, lover, dancing partner, yeah. Even teacher. And you have learned so much from each other these past few years. Now, shortly, you will say a few words that will take you across the threshold of your life, and things between you will never be the same again, because after today, you shall say to the world, "This is my husband. This is my wife." Sounds nice, right? Yeah. Well, do you, Michael, take Stacy to be your loving wife, to share a married life together? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her, in sickness and in health, for richer or poorer, and forsaking all others, keep faithful to her in all ways and forever? Good answer. And do you, Stacy, take Michael to be your loving husband, share married life together? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, for richer or poorer, forsaking all others, keep faithful to him in all ways and forever? Michael, is there something you'd like to say to Stacy?
Well, I'd like to Stacy, thank you for being the woman that you are. You're never changing. You're that person. You know me better than anybody. And somehow you still manage to love me. I promise to invite you, sorry, when you come. I promise to support and encourage your dreams, because that's what makes you who you are. I promise to help burden your challenges, because together we can do anything. You're my first, my last, and my oldest. Thank you for doing this honor tonight and being my wife. I love you.
Biggest accomplishment in life, and for that I promise to be true to you and to be faithful to you. Seeing how you are with your Sally girl, I just fall more in love with you every single day. And I can't wait to continue this amazing journey of ours that's called life, by making tons of babies and asking you you every single day if we could get another puppy. I vow to be your biggest supporter. I will always put you first before anyone or anything else. I promise I will always spray Lysol around the house on my days off. So you think I cleaned all day. And I will most guarantee after today, there will be a package at the front door since you know I'm Amazon Prime's best customer. And I promise I will still throw my temper tantrums when I think you take all of our paper towels. But Michael, I will go above and beyond when it comes to taking care of you and our family. I will accept all of your faults the way you've always accepted mine. You are my once-in-a-lifetime love, and today begins our fairy tale that has no end. Today I marry you with no hesitation or no doubt. You truly are my life, my love, and my best friend, and I will love you until the end of time. From this day forward, I give you my life, and I give you my whole heart. I love you.
Thousands of years, lovers have exchanged rings as a token of their vows. And look, these simple bands are not of great value in themselves. They're made precious by you wearing them. Your rings say that even in your uniqueness, you have chosen to be joined together. So, with this ring, I thee wed. With this ring, I thee wed. You said. Okay. Yeah, it's nice. Well, as strong as Michael and Stacy's bond is, we know that their union does not exist in solitude. We know that in a lifetime together, they will need the love, support, and wisdom of all the friends and family who encircle them today. So I'd like to call on you all to always share your thoughts with them as truthfully and unbiased as possible. Stand beside them and not between them. And come to them with hearts of peace and not of judgment. Show them your kindness, your support, and your loving hearts. So listen, I know you guys are. That's a good thing. In fact, that's about the best thing that can happen to anyone. So don't let people make that light or small to you. And when we speak of love, understand it's simply an outpouring of everything good in you, of kindness and consideration and respect. But not just the social respect of manners, the greater respect, which is the recognition of another person as unique and valuable. It can bring out in you strength and courage and wisdom from deep within inside, but the main thing that anyone here who's married will tell you is, just take it easy, okay? And you can have a whole lifetime together. And Michael and Stacy also expressed a sincere feeling of gratefulness to their parents. And it's hard to find the right words to tell you how they feel. They want to deeply thank you for all you've done. But I believe thank you only begins to say what's in their hearts today. They sometimes took for granted your guidance, your caring ways, you know that, right? And the sacrifices you made for them may have seemed to go unnoticed, but as they start this new chapter in their life together, they want you to know that your love and support for them throughout their lives are amongst their most cherished possessions. Well, Michael, Stacy, we have heard you promise to share your lives in marriage, and we all recognize and respect the commitment you have just made. Look, it's not a reverend in front of you that makes you marriage.